नमस्कार, वेलकम बैक टू येट अनदर स्टोरी ऑफ द मिथ बिहाइंड एन आसना। किंग जनका वॉज अ कर्म योगी, वन हु फॉलोज द पाथ ऑफ सर्विस। जनका'स केयर फॉर हिज पीपल इंक्लूडेड केयर फॉर द लैंड एंड ही वर्क द फील्ड्स लाइक एनी फार्मर। वन डे व्हेन ही वॉज प्लाउइंग ही स्पाइड समथिंग मूविंग इन द फरो अहेड। Afraid he might have disturbed the habitat of some small animal, he stopped and looked. No, not an animal. This small creature was not furry. King Janaka bent down and in wonder lifted a beautiful baby girl from the seat, from the furrow that his plow had drawn in the earth. Her large solemn eyes regarded him calmly. Hello, daughter, said King Janaka. The baby smiled. You will be Sita, he told her, because you were born in a seat, in a furrow. As the daughter of the Mother Earth, Sita represents the physical dimension of the universe, Prakriti, just as Rama personifies Purusha, consciousness. This entire creation, the sages say, springs from the love play between these two principles. To say that Sita was born from a furrow of the earth is another way of saying that we come to understand our own spiritual nature through the medium of the body. When Sita grew up, King Janaka held a huge festival of Swayamvara for her to choose her husband. Of course, it was her destiny to reunite with Lord Vishnu in this birth, as in every birth, and of course, she chose Rama, but that is another story. King Janaka, caring for his physical environment, discovered the goddess. When you nurture your body or mind through the sustained, focused practice of asana, pranayama, and meditation, what does the flow point of your attention turn up? Maybe rocks, roots, and worms at first. But this story tells us that the gift of the divine feminine is there too. How has your practice helped you to discover what lies under the surface of your body and mind? To unearth the hidden treasures in your body and mind, you have to do your own practice, not someone else's, even if their practice seems preferable, says the Bhagavad Gita. Do you need to modify this pose to discover its real benefits? How does this pose foster persistence and concentration over a long, sustained time? A plow creates order in a field. It makes straight furrows to house and protect the seeds, just as a mantra creates patterns in your mind and protects your thoughts. You must control the pressure and speed and direction of the plow, just as a meditator controls the speed and direction of thoughts and breath. There's a story of the Buddha's childhood that says that he received his first insights into meditation by watching a farmer plow. Observing the tip of the plow meet the earth, not too deep, not too shallow, and the long, smooth unfolding of each furrow, each one a match for the one before and the one after it, created a sense of deep calm and alert attention in young Gautama. Just as regular meditation calls forth jewels of insight from the mind and brings us closer to our real nature, the plow creates deep, long, smooth, even channels in the earth and may even reveal hidden treasure. A major prerequisite to practicing halasana is patience. It's one of those asanas which you can't perform half-heartedly because you may seriously injure yourself. You need to be extremely mindful, have great control over your breath and keep steady for at least 15 seconds. Once you build strength and flexibility, you can try and hold this pose for as long as 10 minutes. Regular practice of the plow pose nurtures and rejuvenates the body's entire system. Halasana helps nourish the thoracic and the lumbar regions of the spine. By increasing circulation and suppleness, releases tensions in the neck and throat, alleviates the accumulation of phlegm or mucus in the sinuses and respiratory system, and gradually assists in lengthening and regulating the breath. It has a calming, restorative effect on the sympathetic nervous system. Traditionally, it has been considered as a finishing pose and is usually found near the end of an asana session. Finishing poses help prepare the practitioner for relaxation, pranayama, and meditation.